This is the real KC and JoJo from Monroe, North Carolina. Jodeci, KC and JoJo, tons of hit records, traveled all over the world. A huge success, a dream that we almost messed up. We've seen the highest of highs and the lowest of lows. And we're sick and tired of the space that we are in. That's done, it's over. I wanna live. For 30 days.
30 days,
we let cameras into our lives as we work on getting sober. Are you ready?
I don't regret my career or anything like that, but it's a lot of things I could have done better.
I don't regret anything. No, I do. I do not. Because it was fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jodeci.
And the winner is KC and JoJo.
Made it, y'all. What's up, bro?
I partied every day of my life, just as I did. And I found myself drinking more.
Everybody bring you weed and liquor and girls and all that, and you just don't care? Get Macho Man in. That's KC. Cedric, on the other hand, is looking at KC like this. I don't want to be that man.
I've been their bodyguard for 12 years. I look at them like little brothers. So if something happens to them, it happens to me too.
When you say KC and JoJo, I'm the N in KC and JoJo. I'm a friend, a brother, a manager. We do everything together.
We just became this family because it was just us out there on the road, and we just became one.
JoJo.
KC.
Good times, bad times. Riches, poor.
It's like a marriage.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. How you doing?
How you doing,
KC? Man? Nice to meet
you. Good to see you.
I sought out Pastor Brian for KC and JoJo because I wanted to get somebody with a strong spiritual background. And knowing that KC and JoJo grew up in the church, I wanted to get somebody that could relate to them on a street level as well as on a church level.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. I'm Pastor Jamal Bryan. I'm from Baltimore, Maryland.
Oh, yeah, BMO, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. I want to introduce to you the Weinsteins and my sister, Dr. Tamer Bryan. She's a therapist, works with Dr. Phil.
First thing I did was brought my sister in, clinical psychologist, to deal with the psychological part. I brought in the Weinsteins, husband and wife team who have been proving themselves successful and effective, working with over 5,000 patients to see them get through this process.
I want to show you all something real quick, and then we'll talk a little bit further after that. Gentlemen, tell me, looking at that, was going on in your mind watching that?
Like, wow, was that me for real? Not cool at all.
What were you thinking looking at it?
You saw it gradually getting to that place where, okay, it's getting a little too out of control now. Like, you doing a video, taking pictures, you got a fifth pulling it up like that, drinking it straight? Nah, that's not no pretty sight. Passing out on stage, not no pretty sight. Body exposing, just that's not no pretty sight. You know, that wasn't how we was raised.
This addiction has affected our business a lot, because when you're hot, people will deal with you and they'll put up with your mess. But when you're not, no one wants to see you drunk, and we're losing a whole lot of business because of it.
What do you gain from the drinking?
I've always been a shy type person.
Yeah.
You know, so it just giving me the extra. Uh-huh. I can go out there and perform in front of a lot of people. That's just been me ever since I was a child.
What about for you?
Just like the feeling, you know, to feel free. Mm-hmm. With the help of God and grace of God, I don't want to see those days no more. Ever, ever. When I was drinking, I didn't give a damn. You know what I'm saying? I didn't care what my lady say. I didn't care what my mom and daddy say. I didn't care what nobody say. I was doing that because Casey wanted to do it. Casey's gonna always do what he wanted to.
This is, gentlemen, I think, a Damascus Road experience. This is not a dead end, but we're getting ready to get on the street called Straight. And I want to yield to the Weinsteins to talk about the process, the program, and the commitment that's needed and necessary, and the urgency.
The point where you're at today is a U-turn point. What will happen if you don't do that? Unfortunately, it's not a pretty end. People die.
You thought that you were in a great physical condition. What I see in your blood work that your liver is not that healthy anymore.
It's the third leading cause of death in the United States. So you're well on your way in your very young age not to fulfill your destiny.
It's not worth it. It's not worth losing everything you try so hard. And for what? You did. They still selling liquor.
So you're well on your way in your very young age not to fulfill your destiny.
We need to do something. We're just tired of sitting back and watching them die in front of our eyes.
The good thing is that it can be taken care of if we're gonna start treatment on time.
Okay.
It can be reversible. You know, the name of the treatment is Prometa treatment. And it's a unique treatment.
Casey and JoJo had a long-standing history of substance use disorder. It takes a lot of failed attempts on the road to sobriety. The treatment is designed to decrease their cravings, improve their cognitive abilities, and they will be able to jumpstart their recovery process.
So, you feel like you're ready to move on?
I don't feel as though I'm an enabler for Casey and JoJo, because I can't stop a grown man from drinking. If he wants to drink, he's gonna drink. All I can do is put the right team around them, and hopefully it will stop.
I'm not going back to that dark hole that I crawled out from under. I'm not going back in there. I mean, come on now. What?
Yeah, we're ready. It's time for a change, you know, because I want to see my kids grow, even my grandkids.
Maybe this is it. Maybe this is really the time. I'm thankful and I'm happy for them that they decided to do this. I really am.
You're going to have 3 consecutive infusions. And then the following thing is, which is very important piece, is psychosocial treatment, will be followed by Dr. Tema.
For Casey and JoJo's treatment, three things are gonna be important. I'm gonna need to address their thoughts, their behavior, and their motivation. The biggest issue of all is going to be around their insight. We're gonna have to discover together what their distorted thoughts are. What's the lie they've been telling themselves that has been fueling the addiction?
We're gonna go in this process. We're stripping down to bare basics to build back to foundation. So I'm putting the two of you all in a house together. I got a physical trainer who's coming in to put y'all back in fighting shape. So we're gonna go through a Job, strip down to everything. So at the end of the day, we got one last test before we can write the New Testament of what Casey and JoJo really are gonna walk into. Let me ask Drs. Weinstein and Dr. Brown, if y'all will excuse us for just a moment.
I see two young African-American men who are gifted, but still struggling. I saw a lot of myself in them, that everybody deserves another chance.
All right, gentlemen. I really want to talk at a more intimate kind of level. It was a while ago, they had one of the biggest earthquakes hit Haiti. And a remarkable story, and this guy was buried under a supermarket. His brother stood outside of the supermarket when the police kept telling him, he says, man, you're gonna have to move. Your brother's probably dead now. He says, man, my brother's not dead. I know him. That's my brother. I'm connected to him. I know he's in there. And 17 days later, they pull him out and asked him, how in the world did you come out of it after you were buried and everybody assumed you were dead? He said, man, I knew my brother wasn't gonna leave me. I said, man, that's it right there. Is that when one or the other is buried under something, you all have gonna have to make a commitment that I'm not gonna leave my brother in this process. So if another record ain't ever made, if y'all never go out on tour again, that you walk out of this process as better men. So I need to know, are you all serious about seeing this through, not relapsing it, but you saying, I'm ready to step into a whole nother chapter?
I'm ready, man. I'm ready. You know, I'm 40 years old now. I'm ready, man.
Gentlemen, let's have a word of prayer.
Thank you.
God, I thank you right now for these two brothers who you still call son. Pray right now that you'll put a hedge fence of protection around them. Give them strength, give them courage.
The first couple of times that I went to rehab, I went there quarter pointed. But this time, this was my decision. I'm trying to save my life.
Give them the audacity to fight even when so many people waved a white flag.
We just gonna pull together. I feel myself slipping, at least I'm gonna grab hold onto him and pull myself right back up. And I know he's gonna be there and help me up and the vice versa with me.
I pray that you will embarrass every person who spoke a negative word against him so that you might in fact reveal what was your ultimate plan. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So we're in it together this time. We're going through, we're gonna walk together hand in hand through this fire.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
First treatment went very well. Your blood pressure came down tremendously from 145 to 122. We'll see you tomorrow.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. So we're in it together this time. We're going through, we're gonna walk together hand in hand through this fire.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
It's been a while since Casey and I stayed together. Whew, it's been a while.
Oh, night and day, night and day. We've been different people, night and day, baby.
Like this.
Nice size kitchen.
It's a beautiful home, but the furniture, I wouldn't pick it up myself.
You got bedrooms.
It's nice.
So, y'all figure out the rooms, and I see him about the Apollo show, and I've been back.
Yo,
Yes, sir.
What's up, man?
How you doing?
Oh, Goza. D, I need to talk to you for 1 minute. We brought Casey and JoJo into this house to live together, to be stripped down to bare basics. Beyond the therapy is I'm trying to instill in them a greater level of self-sufficiency. They have been handled with gloves
for 20 years. Catered to. Exactly.
I want to have a process where they're able to be self-sufficient. What's going to be critical to that process is I want them to go through those weeks with just the two of them.
Right.
What is going to be so critical is that Big D and Damon are not enablers to their process. They have to help them and not handicap them. They're not just coworkers, they're a family. And so I'm really praying and believing that the environment Casey and JoJo are in are really one that's gonna push them to the door of development, because if it doesn't, it's gonna take them to the door of destruction.
I'm with you 110%. Whatever. I told those dudes, whatever it takes, I'm gonna make sure they get through this.
Okay, well, we together.
You know what I'm saying?
Thank you. Teamwork makes
all the
dream work. You look good, man.
Feel good.
You all have a big show coming up at the Apollo.
Yeah, we're looking forward to Apollo, man. Every time we go to Apollo, we sell it out. So, awesome. You know, so it's gonna be nice, man.
Yeah.
It's gonna be real nice.
We wanna make sure at the end of this process that they're whole men, not just healed men. Because they can get healed from drinking, but if they're not whole, they'll end up right back in the same place. This is getting ready to be cell block H. Housekeeper's gone, cook gone. Groupies gone, friends gone, and last but not least, Big D is gone.
Where you going? Gone, gone like what?
So you, let me get this together.
Get it together.
Before we go any further.
Yes.
From this house?
Yes.
So who gonna be in it?
Just y'all.
You and your brother.
In this house.
In this house.
They ain't going platinum.
They ain't going platinum.
Tell me what your greatest apprehension is of y'all being in there by yourself.
I don't want to apprehend, comprehend. I don't have nothing to do with none of that.
Anything can happen. You just don't leave two sick people in a house as big as this.
Big D is fired. You want to listen to the pastor? Go by the God's church.
It's stupid. It's dumb. Who would think to do some shit like that?
Big D, let me talk to you.
All right, I'm going to let y'all talk.
Let me talk to the dynamic duo.
Wherever I go, Big D is dead. You know what I'm saying? That's been like that for going on over 10 years now. Uh-oh. JoJo,
don't worry about it.
It's gone.
Don't worry about it.
It's gone.
Don't worry about it.
It's gone. Just a show. It's
don't worry
it's
about
gone.
It.
All the red can come in and say, Big D, go. Hold up.
That Big D done left. Left with red and shit. This ain't no motherfucking joke. I'm the gone.
I hook my shit and ride gear.
Glad I ain't even packed my motherfucking. Take shit too fucking far, man.
Love him. Thank him for his word. Can't wait to visit his church.
If this part of a guy some. What? It ain't no what. Big D, did you see his ass and all that bullshit? If you want to make a motherfucking show, I'll give you a motherfucking show. Because my bag is right there.
Mine too, homie.
That, you did. The Rev said you did. The Rev said it ass right there. I ain't arguing with you, Damon. Look, I'm not arguing with you.
The reality of it is, there's not a lot of people running up on us every day that they would need a security guard there. I like D being there, because at the end of the day, he's going to protect them from themselves.
Yo, grown ass man, y'all going to stop what y'all doing for one day? Don't f*** with me. There's certain things I would go for this, but I'm not going for this.
You know I would tell Big D to go?
No, that ain't what Reverend said.
Is that you and Big D Red, talked about
y'all
it.
Y'all had a conversation.
So if Big D would've just said on his own, he was leaving today. You say I quit?
We ain't staying in this house by ourselves, right. Point blank.
That was a decision that y'all had to make. What did Big D say?
F*** us.
Pretty much.
Dealing with the drama that comes with the alcoholism, but that's, you know, that's part of the job.
D just wouldn't walk out on y'all.
He drove off.
He drove off. That means if Big D's gone, then I have to stay here. All right. So you know the thing we're supposed to do on the Apollo show in New York in a couple of weeks. That situation, it's not happening now. losing the Apollo show the way that we lost it because the people were scared to take a risk or didn't know what they were gonna do, that's something that's been happening more and more every day for the past 7 years.
Because of past things, the last time we were there, just past stuff, they were
tripping. We didn't do shit the last time we was there.
I mean, right now, we cool, but everybody don't know that we cool right now.
So he didn't know that
what's
before the show was talked about.
Are we gonna be going there and be bad boys like
drunk
we used to be?
Or something
yeah, that's gonna
we wasn't
be.
Drunk the last time we went there.
Sure wasn't.
I feel that we're looking at rock bottom. And in my whole thing for putting this thing together was to stop the guys before we hit rock bottom. You know, sometimes when you hit rock bottom, you can't come back up.
You know, with all this shit and kiss
some
my
bullshit.
Ass.
Bullshit.
I'm fucking fucking. I'm gonna hear that bullshit.
What kind of shit is that?
The promoter, man. I got love for 125th Street.
I'm old and pressing to LA anyway.
The promoter said he wasn't with doing the show. It was too big of a risk.
My new motto is kiss my ass.
Are we walking around with a sign saying, kiss your ass for a record deal?
Something just wasn't right, man.
Yeah, but no more pulling down the pants, though.
No. Oh, I can go to JoJo.
You did get wild.
Start taking responsibilities for your actions.
I'm just happy to be alive.
That's a bunch of bullshit.
I ain't tell that dude to do that.
You didn't tell him not to.
You're a liar.
Well, even give me a move. Make your mind up.
I swear to ever again. Walking right out the door.
You punch like a girl.
We're in the process of redeeming ourselves.
Then why are you behaving as a child?
Thought it was f***ed up.
I got all my men back that was in my life before.
If you're gonna go back to drinking, you guys gonna die.